I'm getting started is, of course, with the agenda of our session. Okay. Now, of course, to begin with, let me just go on the top. I hope you would have been through this course outline, which would have been shared with you. We'll be talking about a section called as Introduction to Jira, where we'll be just shaking hands within Jira and understanding that who are you? What kind of, you know, activities, what kind of, you know, process do you handle? What is that you are for? How you can help me, you know, optimize the way I work in my organization, and what is the way I can definitely make my manual activities more interesting and more efficient. So, of course, you will be getting to know a lot about Jira as a part of the first module. And to be frank, you will already have your foundation built up once you are done with your lesson one, that is Introduction to Jira, because we'll be learning a lot of things here, and that is what we will be getting started with. The lesson two will talk about the test management specifically, because most of the time we generally have criticality with the test management, and a lot of testers look forward to have a solution. And being a Scrum Master, I see most of you are Scrum Master here as well, and most of you are new as well. To that extent, we understand that managing the test and test resources becomes a complicated challenge at any point of time for certain organizations. So understanding that how exactly you can manage your test and related resources using something called as Zephyr. Okay, Zephyr is a add-in, or you can call it as a plugin, which will be installed from Marketplace. Like, we have a lot of, you do understand what is Google Play Store or App Store of iOS. The same way here in Jira, we have a Marketplace where you can go and shop for any kind of plugin to enable certain activities within Jira. By default, Jira will give you a lot of options, but if there are certain restrictions, you have a lot of apps to install and enable that activity. And I'll be definitely explaining you everything about that right from the scratch. Then in lesson three, you will talk about the defect management, which is another important aspect of testing or any project, or be it a support project as well. If you're not talking about a software, you know, you can call it as a service request, you can call it as a ticket, or you can call it as an issue or anything like defect. Now, managing that is very, very important for us because it is an issue. It has a negative impact on the product. It has to be resolved, and it has to be resolved well within time with all necessary information. So how exactly we can manage defects within Jira, we will be understanding in the lesson three. As a part of lesson four, you will understand something called as Jira Query Language. Now, Jira Query Language basically stands for a language which is used internally within Jira. So just like SQL, we have JQL. Okay, so within Jira, there is a database, of course. It is a repository. It stores all your information, whatever you create. Thus, it requires you to make certain searches at any point of time. You can do basic searches using filter options. But if you want to do certain advanced searches using JQL, you need to know what is JQL. How do you write that? So we will be getting a little bit on that as well. And we will execute some of the queries and see that how you can make your search more, you know, convenient and easy to handle certain outputs. And of course, we will be talking about generating reports at any point of time. Being a Scrum Master, it is important for you to keep a track on the progress of the project. So at any point of time, you want to generate a report and see that how you're progressing, what your team is doing, who is working on what number of tasks and how many are pending on that. So there are a lot of things which you can actually generate as a part of report, and you can include them on your dashboards as well. And of course, there is something specific called as Jira Agile, which is specific to the Agile interface. Okay, which you will be understanding in more detailed way, that how it can be specific to certain specific boards. Okay, there are different boards you can see here, which we will be exploring in a little more detail. And then, of course, the final section, which means the wrapping up, we will be covering A to Z quick recap and understanding that, yes, this is what we have covered in the 3 days of time. At any point of time, as I was just talking to Vishwana, and if you think that there's something specific which you might have heard from someone, or you saw your colleague doing that on Jira and you didn't understand that what exactly he was trying to do, how he did that. So you are free to share those things with me, and I'm not restricted. I'm not restricted to this agenda. If you think we have some time, and we have this, you know, quality question, I would love to do that. Okay. I would definitely add value by doing such options beyond the agenda as well. Okay. But just keep it restricted to the instance which we'll be working on. All right, team. So I think that we are done with the introduction session of our day one. And now I think I should be getting inside the agenda as on today. So for
Neeraj, yeah. Neeraj, Praveen here. Just one point. So I also hear that the requirements can be actually tracked in the Jira tool itself. So yes. Is that also covered here?
Probably I can show you that tomorrow when we come to the marketplace, because managing a requirement can be done with help of epics and user stories. So okay. That will be just as a type of work item. Okay. So just a type of work item, you will create a epic or you create a user story, and then you create them into tasks or break them into simple tasks and manage it as a part of product or okay. Sprint backlog. So that you will be definitely covering.
Okay. Fine.
Anything else, team, at this point of time, if you have it in your mind? Okay. So, yeah. Anyone?
Yeah. So the Jira software is free download or it is a paid
yes.
software?
It is actually a paid software, but there are certain options where you can have Jira for some time without paying for it. Okay. So I will help you right here. That's what you're going to understand in the first two modules. That is getting started with Jira and how to install Jira. So I'll be exploring everything about that side and I will be telling you. Now, I want to know from all of you before we get into our day one and very first topic, how many of you have access to Jira right now? Is there anyone who has access to Jira to work on it? Or is that no one has?
I do have, but the basic access, we have some restrictions.
Okay, so you're using your professional version of Jira or something?
You're talking about the personal or the in the office corporate you're talking, which access?
I'm talking about personal because I don't want to hamper any of your official data.
No, not then.
Okay. So my question is, anyone has access to the personal version of Jira?
No, neither.
Okay. So all of you are completely as of like no instance you have on your machine. Okay. Now, the second question, what I'm asking you, that are you using a professional company-based laptop or your personal laptop? Because probably sometime you are not allowed to do that work.
Personal only.
Personal.
Okay.
Office laptop.
Personal one.
Personal. Okay, so I see one of you said office.
Yeah, I am Vaijinath.
Okay, Vaijinath. So Vaijinath, okay, I think you can still access your Gmail on that, right? It's not secure.
Yeah,
I have a security policy or something.
I cannot access the Gmail, but I can forward that email to the company email ID and then I can access it.
Okay, no, it's not about that. It's about, probably Jira is accessible, then probably you can access because generally your office laptops are configured with, connected with VPNs and other things. So they generally keep a track on what links you are accessing and what is that you're trying to do. So not sure. You might have to check with your security team that if you are allowed to do a personal installation of, not installation, basically, you will be using a cloud instance. So ask them for cloud instance of Jira, that can I make use of a cloud instance of Jira to practice? So if they approve that request, you can do the installation. Okay.
Otherwise, I do have a personal laptop.
Then please, simultaneously, you can have that on and you don't have to do anything else.
Yes, sure.
Yeah. For learning, you can use this, your office laptop. But for practices, please have a different laptop because I don't want you to get into trouble. I know the consequences.
Right.
Okay. Thank you so much, team, for all these information because this is kind of like prerequisite. Yes, Prasanna, you have anything?
No, Neeraj, no.
All right. Thank you. Because if I see you on unmute, I wonder that I missed you something.
Neeraj, I have a small question. So I think somewhere you mentioned about tracking the requirements in EPIC and initiative.
Yes.
Right? So will you be showing us about creating a user story and tracking the related? Okay, yeah, sure. That
everything. Yeah. Don't worry. All right. Thank you so much for that contribution there. We will be getting started shortly. So now, again, please follow the principle number one, which I told you, that is during the demonstrations, have your complete attention on the screen and try to understand everything, because I'll be probably showing one click, but I'll be talking about 10 statements on that click. So that is what you grab from a training. Otherwise, you can learn from YouTube videos or Udemy sessions as well, right? Of course, you have a free option, but why are you in a training? By making a payment for that, because you want to explore something more. So make sure that you have complete attention on the screen when I'm talking. And after that, of course, I'll give you a lot of time to do those practices back again on your screen or on your machine. All right. So now the very first thing which we are getting started is to say hello to the Jira. Now, let me start sharing my screen. And if anyone has any issues viewing my screen, please report. Okay, so right now my screen should be visible to all of you. Is there anyone who is not able to see the screen? Just drop me a chat. So the very first thing to start with is we will be first setting up an instance, a private instance for us, okay? So that you can do everything in Jira at your private space and nobody else knows what is that you're doing and you are completely confidential. And at the same time, you have a freedom to get all the access what you might have at any point of time. So all you have to do is you have to go to Atlassian, atlassian.com, okay? But if you just come here, there are some recent changes happening. And this is your only website to get any kind of product from the Atlassian. Atlassian is the company which has created this product called as Jira. And if you come here on the menu option, you will see that there are products. Just drop down here and you will see all the products which are there in the market from Atlassian. So Jira is one of the project, or one of the product. Okay, we have, and we have versions or variants of Jira. We have Jira software for project and issue tracking, Jira Align, which is another product that we have called as Enterprise Agile Planning. And then we have Jira Core, Jira Service Management, OpsGenie, Status Page, Confluence, Trello, Bitbucket, SourceTree, Bamboo, Atlassian Access, and Crowd. So these are a lot of different things. And probably in your organization, you might have heard of these other variants as well. Because when it comes to an organization, they're just not restricted to Jira software. They make use of Confluences as well to manage their documentation. They make use of Jira Service Management. If they are talking about the task management or service desk or ticketing management, then they make use of Jira Service Management. So there are different things to manage different part of your project, okay? And different types of project. So all these variants are available to anyone in the world who just wants to make use of Jira for their specific needs. And of course, I'll be giving you some basic outline for some of the important parameters here or important products here, which are common in the world today. But of course, there are certain things which are completely extinct that not all of them use it. Only few organization, limited organization makes use of it. Then we will just skip those things, right? But yeah, of course, I'll give you highlights of most of the things here so that at least you know that what this product is about, all right? We will be mainly making use of Jira software, which is for project and issue tracking. Okay, so all our entire session, whatever your queries and questions you ask me right now, and the agenda we have looked on, we will be covering it with help of Jira software, and we will understand all the concepts. Now, if I go to Jira software, I see that it will take me to the Jira page, and it says that get it for free, which means that I can use it for certain duration without paying anything. Okay, so I can just go here and go for get it free. But before I click on this button, I would like you to have a look on a basic introduction to Jira so that you know what exactly Jira is and how we can start working on that. Okay, so getting started with the first, very first part of our Jira session. What is Jira? Why should we use Jira? What are Jira products? And which agile methodology is used in Jira? This will answer your very first foundation questions or basic foundation level information about Jira, and at least build up that basic understanding that what are you trying to understand. Now, of course, Jira is a tool developed by an Australian company called as Atlassian. It is a bug tracking tool initially. When Jira was first created as a product, it was generally created for bug tracking because that was a challenging thing as a part of your project initially. And Atlassian contributed to the market with something called as Jira and helped them to call it as issue management tool. Now later they optimized it, upgraded it, and made it to project planning and tracking tool. Okay, so that was the transition. Because initially we had really good challenges to manage the defects, and a lot of defects used to slip away because of proper or improper management of the defects. So we wanted a good solution every time in the market. Following that, of course, it helped you to manage a lot of other things which you saw on the list of the product. So each product of Jira, or sorry, Atlassian, is from different point of view. The word Jira basically comes from a Japanese word called as Gojira, which means Godzilla. That means it's kind of big. You know, Godzilla, you know the term. So which means that it's everything. It's going to have all the things what you need, and it's quite huge. And of course, Jira is an ocean. Probably whatever you will be learning is just one segment of it. But of course, you need that one segment right now. Being later into the different parts of different domains of organization, you would need different products. But at this point of time, when you're talking about being into an agile process or talking about task management, talking about requirement management, issue management, ticketing management, you will cover everything in this session. Okay. Now, Jira helps you to do many things, including project management, issue tracking, tracking and monitoring, workflow management. What do you mean by that? Project management is, of course, the entire project schedule and the activities which happens within a particular project. Issue tracking is any kind of activity. Issue is the common word used in Jira because they call any activity as an issue by default. But this issue can be a task, can be a user story, or can be a bug, can be a test as well. Okay, but in Jira, we call it as an issue because that's the title they have given. Initially, they created as an issue tracking tool, right? So they still have the name called as issue. But of course, an issue can be of different types. We have different variants like user story, task, bug, or test, or maybe anything else which you want to have. Tracking and monitoring, which is very important aspect of any project. Just planning and scheduling activities is not important. At any point of time, being a good manager or probably Scrum Master, you need to have a good tracking source. And tracking generally helps you to identify any kind of deviations from the schedule or plan which you have laid out. At any point of time, if you see any kind of deviations from your schedule or plan, then you take necessary control actions to overcome that deviation. And that can only happen if you are having a proper tracking and monitoring plan deployed. Okay, so Jira will assist you with that as well, to keep an eye on every activity which happens within the project and give you necessary reports or necessary updates at different interval of time to keep you posted with the tracking and monitoring activities. Whereas workflow management stands for what kind of workflow your activities will make use of. I hope you would have seen certain workflows already with different activities or different softwares. Generally, once a particular issue is logged in a system, then what is the life cycle of an issue is called as a workflow. For example, if you talk about human beings, of course, human beings start with getting born and then continue to their childhood, then get into teenagers, and then become the adulthood, and of course, the senior citizens. And during this span, they have different variants. They have different commitments. They have different objectives. Probably in childhood, you wanted to be something. But later when you grew, you realized that this is not my cup of tea. So you moved into some other domain. When you got settled, you probably got married and then you got children. So you had a different objective. Now you wanted to build a career or bright future of the kids rather than yours. So things changes, right? So similarly, when we talk about different projects, different domains, domain basically stands for any kind of segment. like banking, healthcare, e-commerce, or aerospace. So different domains have different objectives. Different projects comes with different expectations. So of course, the workflow will also be different. So how, what is that workflow and how do you can set it up in order to see that this is what I need and this is what should happen? So yes, workflow will help you to understand that, that how your each activity will be traveling through a life cycle. And that's what you call it as workflow management here. So yes, we will be covering one each one of these here in our session by one or the other way. So please stay tuned for that. Following that, of course, main usage is planning, tracking, and support. Support is from the customer support point of view. Generally, a lot of organization who work on the back end to customer to support their customers and of course take their service request. So generally, if one fine day your washing machine is not working, you just give a call to a toll-free number starting with 1-800. And they say that, yes, we have logged your complaint, sir. This is your service request number. One of our executive will be there at your place and resolving the issue. Now, that's where an issue is logged. Of course, the support management plays a vital role because I should not miss any tickets or I should not miss out any service request raised by any customer. That's how you fulfill the quality part in the second half of the product. First half is by delivering the product. Second half is by giving proper assistance. So that's where Jira is also helpful in managing all these support services or ticketing management as well. Additionally, of course, what else do you get in Jira? We have projects, we have issues, workflow, search. Search is a very important thing. It's just not simple to say like Google search that you go to Google and type something and search for it. No. Here we mean that when we start working on a project, probably I would have created around thousands of defects, right? Or thousands of issues raised by different customers. How do I search something specific? Do I have certain specific criteria with me? Like I want to see only the tickets with priority high and status open. This is what we call it a search here. So search is just not about typing something and getting the output. Search plays a very important role in any kind of software. That if you don't have a good search options, probably you have to still do your manual activities. And that could be tedious. So search is the best option which you are getting as a part of Jira software as well. Because every software has this feature, Jira also has this. Plus the dashboards. Dashboard is basically a place where you can add multiple indicators. Indicator means a matrix, a calculation, which is going to tell you that what exactly are you trying to monitor. And dashboard at one place, you can see all the indicators, which will update you that how your different indicators are progressing. Okay, so at any point of time, you want to see multiple things at one place, you make use of dashboard, just like your car dashboard. Because why do we call it as dashboard of a car? The reason is it has multiple indicators at one place. You can see your speedometer, you can see accelerometer, you can see your fuel indicator and many other things on your dashboard, right? That's the reason you call it as a dashboard. Same way here, the dashboard will be there and we will be understanding about the same. Further to add, of course, why should we use Jira? That's the most important question. There are so many competitive tools in the market and they have got good features as well. Why Jira over them? Jira is fully customizable. When I say fully, it means that. What do you mean by that? That means completely end to end, this tool can be customized right from the creation of an instance or installing the version till the moment you want it to be used. Okay. Anything what you see in Jira or you will be seeing in Jira from today can be customized. That means it can be changed based on your project specifications or organization structure or needs. And that's the best feature why Jira is trending today, because it is just not specific. Believe me or not, you can even change the logo of the Jira in the product because they give you that much freedom that if you're using within your organization, you should always see your organization logo, not my logo. They have even given that option to customize. You can even change the color and layout of the entire Jira software. So all these are possible. Okay, Jira is a platform independent tool. That's the next benefit. That means you don't have to be restricted that if you're using Microsoft Windows, then only you can use Jira. No. You can use it on any software, be it Macintosh, Linux, or Windows, anything. You can make use of it. Jira is a multilingual tool. That means multi-language. You can use it in any languages, just like Facebook or LinkedIn. You can switch between the languages. If you want to use it in German, you want to use it in Spanish, you want to use it in Japanese, you don't have to stick yourself to English. Okay? So if you want, you can even change the language of the entire tool to your local language, and the tool can be localized. Jira can support MySQL, Oracle, PostgreSQL, and SQL Server in the backend. We have to understand at this point of time that Jira is a database, or technically we call it as a repository, because you will be creating a lot of things. And of course, it needs a database to store everything, whatever you create. So of course, what kind of database Jira can support? So as you can see, Jira can support SQL to NoSQL, anything. So Postgres are your NoSQL example, and you can even have a SQL Server installation, like the operating system, and you can make use of Jira there as well. Okay, so any database is supported. Jira can be run locally in a company data center or in cloud, and is licensed accordingly. Okay, so this is a paid tool. We call it as commercial tool. So it's not basically a freeware, but Jira has given different versions to their users so that everyone feels comfortable to make use of Jira. So some of the small organization can avail free version of Jira for lifelong, but it has certain restrictions. We will understand it in a while. Second, we do have the cloud instance or their physical server instance. Now, server instances are used by the organization who has a big crowd and of course can afford a server in their in-house premises. And they can install a server version and have all their data related to their organization within their premises. But there are organizations who are small startups and they cannot afford a server in their premise. It might be very expensive for them. For them, we have cloud. We have cloud instances that you can host servers from Jira itself, that is Atlassian, and create your instance there, and all your data will be secured by them. Of course, they have a privacy policy and data confidentiality clause, so that whatever data you are storing in their databases will not be released or leaked like Twitter and Facebook to anyone else. Okay, so those kind of things are also available. So you have a lot of things to explore, but right now we are just restricted to a basic introduction. Jira can be integrated with many other tools. That's the most important benefit. Generally, when you have a very good solution for your organization, but there are a few things which you might be managing in a different tool. And that time you wonder that, I wish I could export these informations to Jira from a tool XYZ, right? But you see no provision. That means I cannot integrate this tool to the Jira software. Now that's what the problem will happen, because you still have to import manually and export manually or upload it manually to Jira. So that's where Jira has given this provision to all their users that it can be integrated with all particular famous tools in the market today, like Subversion, Git, ClearCase, Team Foundation software, Mercury softwares, which is now gone to Micro Focus. In between it was gone to HP. So I hope you know what is Mercury, like Quality Center, if you remember, LoadRunner, Quick Test Professional, QTP. So all these tools were from Mercury, which was later taken over by HP and now finally taken over by Micro Focus. So all these tools now live with Micro Focus. So all these softwares can be integrated with Jira, plus concurrent version systems and many more. So whatever you see, like Bitbucket, Git, so all these softwares can be integrated with Jira. So ease of access and that convenience, what you need to have within your organization is given by Jira. So you don't have to worry about anything. If you have Jira, then whatever else you are using can be very well integrated and managed through Jira itself. Okay, so a lot of things. And of course, countless add-ons to further enhance the functionality. So that's what is Marketplace. In the marketplace, if you think that Jira does not have anything by default, You can just go to marketplace and shop for any vegetables or fruits and just install that on Jira and enable that feature. Okay, so Atlassian has verified all these products, all these plugins, and you just have to be safe and secure in going and installing that product. And we will do that. I'll show you a demonstration of going to marketplace and installing a add-on that is Zephyr for test management. Okay, because by default, Jira does not offer test management. Okay, so these are a few of the things which we just want. Of course, there are various versions I've shown you on the homepage. We have major versions as Jira Software, Jira Core, and Jira Service Desk, which is now called as Jira Service Management. This happened just a few weeks ago, around 2 weeks ago. They changed the name from Jira Service Desk to Jira Service Management. And which Agile methodology is used in Jira? Of course, you know, there are different variants of Agile. When you talk about Scrum, Kanban, Scaled, or even mixed Agile approaches like Crystals and other things, XP, right? Jira supports everything. You can make use of Scrum, you can make use of Kanban, or even if you can have your mixed methodology, you know, where it's just a combination of few other approaches of Agile. You can, you know, be making use of that as well within your Jira software. Plus, even the Scale Agile is supported. So everything, no matter what you're using today as a part of Agile methodologies, you will be accommodated in Jira software very well, okay? You don't have to just wonder that, what if I'm using Kanban? What if I'm using Scaled Agile? Or what if I'm using a mixed approach? Jira supports everything because it is 100% customizable. You can just customize as per your need. If you need it, we have it, that's all. Okay, well, so these are the things which we have just covered, and now we will be getting back to our Jira software. Now, at this point, do you have any questions?
You said that we can use mixed means Kanban and Scrum, both can be mixed.
Yes.
Okay.
So hi, Neeraj. Neeraj, how do we determine which Atlassian product will be best suited for our organization? For example, we saw many different products for Jira. So how to determine which will be the best suited for our projects or organization?
It completely depends on your needs, Nidhi. First of all, that you need to decide what are your problems. For example, is it a requirement management? Is it about test management? Or is it about ticketing management? And then you see we have a lot of heavy documentation. So you just determine those things first. And then, you know, look into Atlassian, that what kind of solutions they have. So Jira software will actually take your end-to-end project management, be it Agile or traditional model, and Confluence will handle from the documentation point of view. If you are also having a customer support, like who is taking care of your end product after the release, then you can have Jira Service Management to manage the ticketing. And there are similarly many other things. What if your codes are being, you use a continuous integration, okay, to develop your product. Then you have a lot of codes managed in the Bitbucket or Git, right? You merge your code through that. Then of course, that will be again another component which you can integrate. So this is how you go about that.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Neeraj.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. Anything else, team? Okay. So now let's get back to our installation part. And here I'll be showing you the steps to set up your account. So you see that probably I'm already, having an account, but he's asking me to log in because of course I've done several sessions on Jira and probably I don't have enough email IDs left out, but let's see if I can use any of the other instances. So what you have to do is, first step, you have to go to Atlassian.com. Okay, step number one, then come to Jira software. Now, the next important thing here, Jira has two major variants for installation, okay? Please don't confuse yourself with the products. We have n number of products here, correct? Now I'm talking about the installation. We have two different variants of installation and we call it as type of instance. Okay, let me just make use of a whiteboard rather. Okay, so when it comes to the installation of Jira products, they have two types of instances or installation. Number one is cloud-based and second is server-based. What do you mean by cloud-based? That means you cannot afford a physical server in your organization, but you want to make use of Jira. Then you can go for a cloud instance. Okay, cloud instance. That means you can create an instance of your Jira software on Atlassian's cloud, Atlassian servers and data centers, and you can make use of product. Okay, you don't have to worry about having a server on your organization. But if you're a bigger organization and you don't want to put your data somewhere outside, then you can obviously have a server in your organization and you get a different instance version to install that on the server, which is your physical servers. So right now, as we see that we do not have a server, we will be using the cloud instance of the Jira software. The software which we will be using is Jira software. Okay, this is the product which we'll be using to learn everything. And we will be using the cloud instance of that. The benefit of cloud instance, what you will get here is that, first of all, the cloud instance will allow you to have freedom to use the product for no cost, okay, up to certain users. And then it is available for lifetime. Lifetime for that limited user. You don't have to pay at all. But its limited user is up to 10. But any organization may have more than 10 people. That's where they charge for the license. But up to 10 users, you don't have to pay anything to them. But of course, cloud will not allow you to make any administrative changes. Okay, that's the only drawback which they give with the cloud instance. That means you cannot customize everything what they promise you in their Jira product. Okay, because you are using a free version of this for the lifetime, then I cannot give you all the features. But of course, the basic project management and tracking and all major options will be there and you can work on it. But the same thing, this admin access is provided in a server instance. So you have to do a server installation and then you will have the control over the tool to manage or customize anything in the entire Jira software. Okay. So right now for the training purpose, we will be using a cloud instance and that is very simple. You just have to create an account and register yourself. That's it. And you are ready to use. But in server, you have to do the server installation first, create the account, then create users, and all these activities will be right from zero. Right from scratch, you have to start everything. Okay. So please be aware that there are two instances, because tomorrow when you wonder that how exactly this is different, then you see that, oh, I learned on cloud instance, but this is a server instance. And another important thing which I should tell you here at this point of time, that you will have slight, simple look and feel changes also between cloud and server instance, but slight. It will not be completely different. So it's not that if you're learning on the cloud, you cannot work on the server instance. Very well. 90 to 95% the server and cloud instance look and feel are same. Options are also same. Just another 5% will be slightly different. Okay, that I'll be highlighting you during our session, that what are those options which we will see differently in server. Okay, so this is one important thing which you should know before you can begin your installation or setting up your cloud instance. So let's go back to our
Neeraj,
yes please.
Server instance also free for 10 users or it is chargeable? No.
It's chargeable. They only give you 30 days trial period for servers instance. So you can install that. 30 days, it will be free of cost. And after that, they will ask you to purchase the license.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Neeraj, the marketing team from sales team has to approach from the organization and with the Atlassian to get the access to.
Yes. Okay. Exactly. All right, so we are here right now. So these are our products. So let's go to Jira software. And you saw the last time I showed you the button that you have a button called as get it for free. So just click on this button called as get it for free, or you can even click on get it for free. If you want to see the pricing, you can click on this. You can see the pricing, features, product guide, and enterprise solutions. And then you have a buy now button here on the homepage itself. But right now we will be looking for get it for free. Click on this button and it will take you to that free setup. Now, they are saying you have selected Jira software. I hope you are just listening to this. Please do not imitate my activities right now because you will miss a lot of things. Okay. Just listen to this or probably make steps, you know, simple notes. So here are on the left side, you will see what all features you will get for free. That is supports up to 10 users or 3 agents. 3 agents are basically kind of like host who can, you know, control the things like project managers and all. Includes 2 GB of storage. That's the limitation on free version. And offers community support. Of course, you can take any kind of support from the Atlassian community. That means you will, if you are stuck at any point of time, you can access the community page of the Atlassian and get resolution of your query anytime. And it is always free, no credit card required at the time of registration, which means that a lot of people say that, you know, initially it will be free, but after 2 months, you will be charged. After 1 month of 30 period trial period, you will be charged automatically. So you have to put your credit cards at the time of registration itself. No. So that's what they're saying. No credit card needed at this point of time. That means you will be free for the lifetime, but these constraints, 10 user or 3 agent, 2 GB of storage. Beyond that, if you go, then of course you will not be able to use or do anything beyond that. And then you will have access to community support. Plus, select a second product. Of course, our first product, which we have selected, is Jira Software. And the second option is, do you want Confluence as well as Jira Service Management? If you want both of them, or Jira Software with Service Management or Jira Software with Confluence, you can select them right here. They will automatically configure both the tools for you and you can make use of it. So it's up to you if you want to have any add-ons, but because it will not interrupt you to do any activities. If you want, you can install it, but you know, we will not be getting into that right now in our session. I'll just give you an overview of that. So you can just leave it to Jira Software. But if you are excited to explore a little more about those things, please select both the options. Okay, that's up to you. It will not interrupt you to learn any activity what we will be covering. And then click on next. You can see still here, they say that no credit card required. So they are giving that comfort to their users that believe that it's completely free. Okay. So click on next at this time. And then the next page will ask you to set it up. What is that? Get started. So sign up with email or your Google account. So you can use your Gmail account or create a separate account by using your personalized email ID or whatever it is. So if I go with sign up with email, it will prompt me to use an email ID. Purposefully, they just mention it as work email, but not mandatory that you should use your official email ID or all this, because you don't want to have these kind of things going to your official email IDs, right? So you can put your email ID here, password, first name, last name, and agree. That's it. So let me just try if I have any email IDs pending, because generally I have used these instances and they're already created. If not, don't worry, I have a backup. I'll use the already existing instance. So let me use this email ID and he will update me. Oops, an Atlassian account with this email ID already exists. Okay. Okay. Probably I have to, you know, use something else. I just wanted to show you the process of setting up everything right from the scratch. Okay, give me a moment. Let me just create a quick email ID. That's not a big deal, right?
Can't you use Mailinator IDs?
Sorry?
Mailinator.com is there, right? Just you will get the mails to your inbox. That's it. You can't send anything. And for test mails kind of stuff. This is the stuff.
Okay. Okay. No, I'm not sure. I've not used that ever before. Any idea how to do that?
Just give it a try. I mean, I don't know how to what extent Jira can send the mails to Mailinator.
Jira will only send you a verification email to verify that this is your email ID. That's it. Other than that, they will send only promotional mail. Okay, just give me a moment. Then I'll just set it up a quick count. Because I want to show you everything from the scratch so that you learn. Okay, so this is done. So this is the new email ID. So let me reshare my screen with all of you. Okay, so I'm using a different email ID which I just created. That's called as my email ID, neeraj@gmail.com. And you just have to set up a password. Let me just go with a simple password which you can remember. Okay, it should be at least 8 characters. So I'm going with an 8 character password and they're saying it's weak. So let me just create a stronger password. That's up to you, okay? It has nothing to do with your security point of view. But yeah, when doing it professionally, you need to make sure that your passwords are highly secure. Okay. Let's click on agree. So the next step will be, of course, verification, which sees a bicycle. I don't think there are no bicycles here. Skip. Parking meter, of course, just to. Why we are doing this as a part of the session, because at any point of time, if somebody says that I know how to work on Jira, then you should know that how exactly to set it up and what are the steps involved so that you can even tell anyone. See, when you go back from the training, you tell people that I was just going through a Jira training for the last 3 days. Then they ask you, oh, I also wanted to work. Is there a possibility that I can work on it? without having a professional version of it, then you can say, yes, it's simple. You can go for a cloud instance without any kind of fees and you can make use of it for lifelong. So these are the things which you should know. Okay, they have sent me an email here. So they will be sending you an email as well when you register. So let me just refresh and see if I've got the mail. Okay, so now this guy has identified that I'm already logged in from some other account. Okay, you can just do the registration part and hold on there. Meanwhile, let me just get this resolved. Okay. Go to atlassian.com and just fulfill the steps there.
Neeraj, I have a small question.
Please.
So like some of the requirements, I was just checking the LinkedIn and I came across some of the requirements like expert in very good in Confluence. And you just mentioned Confluence is only for the documentation and collaboration, right?
Yeah.
So, and the requirement was for Scrum Master. So how we can relate Confluence with the project management? Do we have any option to customize that again?
Yes, of course. See, being a Scrum Master, of course, you need to have a good understanding of Confluence as well. The reason is because most of the organization manage their resources using Confluence. See, Confluence is a product of Atlassian, which is mainly used for managing the work products. Okay, any kind of work products, be it a requirement document or test plan or organization policy, or test policy, strategy, any kind of written documentation. The reason is it is shared, it is secured, and it is accessible. For example, at any point of time, you want to add a description for an issue that you are writing this user story, but this user story is taken from where? Like traceability. Then you can immediately include a Confluence link if you are already having a Confluence and your requirements are managed there, and it'll be simple. Just get it there. Okay, so being a Scrum Master, of course, they will ask you as a profile that you should have learning of Confluence as well, that how to do it. But it's not that critical like Jira software. It is simple. Okay. Yeah.
But like, you know, usually if we have Confluence, it is a must to have Jira, either Jira or Rally project management tool where we have defect tracking as well as, you know, all the sustenance work, right?
Of course, of course.
Okay, thank you.
Sure. Okay, so I don't know how far you have reached, but I think I have resolved this problem. I've got this mail here, almost there. Please verify your email ID. So please come back to the screen team please concentrate on the Zoom screen right now. And yeah, so you see that I did my registration here. Great, check your inbox. That means they have sent a verification mail and I have created an email ID, which is just a dummy email ID. Please don't drop any email on this. Probably I'll be deleting it after the session. So almost there, please verify. So just click on this mail and you have a button here, verify my email address. As you click, it will again take you to the Atlassian account, which you just created. But now they will start setting up your instance. Okay, please keep the, you know, keep a track on the words. What we have done here, we have made use of a cloud instance. What is other instance? Server instance. Okay, server instance requires physical server. Cloud instance just requires your machine because it will be hosted somewhere else. So now we are using cloud instance. The step one was to register. After registration, you have to verify your account, email ID. And then once you verify, you will be on this page. Okay, for the first time, only for the first time. Next time when you log in, these things will not be appearing because this is only for the initial setup. Now here they're asking you, invite your teammates. That means who all are going to work with you. Now remember, as a cloud instance free version, you can have up to 10 colleagues of yours on this instance to contribute and work. Now, if you have any colleagues, you can give them an invite by dropping their email ID. Now, what happens there? When you put their email ID here, for example, james@xyz.com. Now, James will receive an email invitation. Once this James clicks on that link, he will be also asked to create an account, okay? He will be creating an account just like how you created right now. And then he will be joining you in your project. That's it. Okay. So when you write the email ID, the person receives an invite link and clicking on that link, he has to register first and then join your team. If he already has an account in Jira, you can include him in your project. That's it. You don't have to recreate the account. You just have to join your project. That's it. So if you want, you can have some email IDs here. Or if you want, you can just leave it because you will be working alone on this instance. So let my teammates invite other people also. If you want to allow, you can allow that or you can disable that. Only you will send the invitation to add people. Click on continue. Now, this is just a basic thing, okay? This setup is just a simple thing. If you want, you can do it or you can just randomly select anything or skip, okay? Because rest all, we will be doing it in the training. So don't worry about that. They ask you, am I dash like new to Jira or experienced with Jira? So let's go with our audience level. Let's say new to Jira. I don't know anything about Jira. My team is dash to agile methodologies, new to agile methodology or experience. I say experience. I know about agile, but I don't know about your product Jira. We spend our time working on what? Feature, support, or fixing bugs. So let's select, all of us should select. Let's go for features right now. Okay, I'll tell you the other things later. So these are the options which I'm selecting. You can also select the same. We have dash schedule to finish our work, tight schedule or flexible. So say we have tight schedule. So this is just going to do some slight, templates and other things, but it's not going to impact your overall project that we will be creating right from the scratch. So just fill up some information here. But this one, third option, please select features, because that will change the layout of your project. If you're using a support operation, the workflow will be different, okay? But if you're using features for Agile, workflow will be different. So please select features here and rest all, keep it like new to experience with and tight schedule. Say next. If you want, you can skip, so you know that. If there is an option called a skip, that means this is not going to impact your architecture at all. Now, select a template. What type of project you are working on? When you're saying that you are experienced with Agile, is it a Scrum, is it a Kanban, or is it a bug tracking specifically? For example, issue management. Entire project is about managing the issues. Now, what is that your project is all about? So let me say that I'm using a Scrum project. So select it. Then they ask me, what do you want to give the name to the project? Because this is your first look or first time you are visiting this particular instance, and you don't have any projects. So if you want, you can create a project here. And later also, if you want, you can add projects to this. Okay, it's not that only one project you can create. You can create multiple projects. But right now, they're asking you to create one project. So let me just name it as Star Agile Training. Sorry, I should have given space because I was following some other thing. A lot of softwares, a lot of protocols. Okay, so I'm naming my project as Star Agile Training. You can name it as whatever you want. And there will be a key generated by the first letter of each word, like S-A-T, SAT. Okay, if you want, you can further customize it if you want something like star. Okay, so it's up to you. It's just a key, like shortcut, to know that which is your project. And this will be used as a reference for any activity which you do throughout the project. If you create user story, issues like bug, test, everywhere this prefix key will be there to say that it is a star one, star two, star three. So project prefix will be used in the short form. And that's what is key. So if you want, you can have customized key. By default, it will take the first letter of your project name for all the words. So right now I'm just renaming it to star. And then still, if you want, you can change your template here. If you click on this, it will take you to the previous page. You can switch between Scrum or Kanban and again, come back to this. Or you can just click on create. Now that's where your account will be and your project will be created. And welcome to Jira. Okay, this is your first look of Jira. So these are the simple steps. Just register yourself. Verify your account, invite people if you want to, then select the template of your project type. We will look into other templates, don't worry, okay? I'm not skipping anything. That's the reason I'm highlighting here. We will look into the other templates later, once we have understood everything. And the third thing is, of course, create a project. So once you create the project, you are now inside your Jira instance. Which instance? Cloud instance. You can see your URL here. Please copy this. Okay, please copy this and paste it somewhere, which you will access in day two, day three, and after the training as well to refer anything. Without this link, you cannot log in here. Okay, so first you have to copy this link till .NET. Okay, till .NET, and then enter. They will automatically ask you to log in to your instance. All right, so this is your cloud instance ID. So please make a note of this link till .NET and save it somewhere. For at least next 2 days. After that, it's up to you. But for the next 2 days, please have this link. And remember your user ID and password. If you forget that, unfortunately, you have to re-register. Okay. So three things are important: link, user ID, and password. Now, it's time you should work on these things till here and come to this welcome page. And once all of you are here, we will continue ahead. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, please ask.
Neeraj, one question. So when we logged in with the Gmail, right, it is asking your site name. Can we give any name or anything specific?
I'm so sorry. What do you mean by site name?
Let's get started. Give your site a name. So choose.
Okay. Yeah. They actually figured me out. That page I missed here. So you like for me, if you see here, I've got team-1610. This, right? So if you want, you can give a customized name instead of that. That is the site name.
Okay.
All of you, that applies to all of you because you are registering for the first time. For me, they know me very well. Atlassian knows me. This guy is crazy and he creates a lot of fake account. So you can have your own custom name for the site as well. So team, please make sure that if you are getting stuck at any point, please don't do unwanted activities there because you will not remember what you did. So if you get stuck, please hold on there. Ask me, I'll help you. Then continue the process till you get this page. After this, do whatever you want. I can recover you. But before that, I will not know what exactly you did.
Neeraj, Prasanna here.
Yes, please.
It is asking me to answer the quick questions like, okay, what type of team do you work in actually? So then
yes, that's what. So say like you're working in feature or kind of feature works, and you are new to Jira.
No. Actually, the page is coming like, okay, welcome to Jira software, Prasanna. Answering these quick questions will help us personalizing your experience. We'll keep your info safe in accordance with our privacy policy. sales.
Will it be possible for you to share the screen if you don't mind?
Sure, no problem. Yeah.
To see if you have access.
Host and disabled.
Yeah, experience the same.
Okay. Manoj, are you here? Manoj? Okay. Yeah. Can you please take a screenshot and drop it on the chat? That you can do.
Sure. I can do that.
Yes. Anyone else had some question there?
I got the same page, but I just skipped it.
Okay. Yeah. Let me look into this. Probably I'm not getting it. If I look into that, I'll get it. What exactly it is. This is the reason I wanted to do a press installation, because I wanted to show you each and every page, but still Atlassian detected me. Oh, not sure again. Can you check on the chat, Prasanna? Do you have an option to share the file?
That's what I'm looking actually. I think
because only host and co-host will have the rights of sharing file.
Yes, I don't have actually. Okay. I don't have option of sharing them.
One moment, please.
Neeraj, it is asking me what type of team do you work in? So, software development.
Yeah, sorry. You were saying about what type of team you're working in, software development. Yeah, you can say that.
That's what actually we are asking me as well.
Okay. Got you. You are on that page. Okay, just give me a moment still. Because
there are a lot of options like, okay, marketing, human resourcing, IT support,
I know.
Yeah, operations. Yeah.
Wait, Manoj is coming here. You'll just give me the host rights, then I can allow you to share files.
Okay.
Anuj Venu here.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I'm in the create project page when it's asked me to key in project name, which I've given something. And the second option I have is project template. There are two options, Kanban and Scrum. Which one I need to select?
Select Scrum right now. We will later work on Kanban as well.
Okay, thank you.
Sure, you're welcome. Thank you, Manoj. I just made you co-host. Thank you. Okay, Prasanna, I'll make you for the time being as co-host. You can share your screen and then you can give up the rights of co-host.
Okay.
You'll have a button on share screen and you can only share a particular window as well.
Safari, okay. It is taking me to securities and privacy grant access, actually.
Okay, so again, yeah. Anyone else can share me that screen, which that question is having? Sylvia, you also had that same thing, right?
Yeah, I just skipped the questions.
Yeah, same here, Neeraj.
Okay, so I'll do one thing. Venu, I'll give you access to this.
No, I'm using a different machine. The one which I'm listening to
is different. Sylvia, I'll give you access to that. You are on the same page?
I'm in this. I'm able to navigate. I'm in the final board, whichever you.
Okay, anyone else on the question page? Okay, then Prasanna, just take a screenshot and you can share me now, the screenshot at least. You will have a, next to your chat option, you will have a button called as file. Just click on that and you can share.
I assume the folks can skip that particular option, Neeraj.
Okay, there is a skip option, right?
Yeah.
Hey, just skip that then. You didn't tell me that before. I don't remember. If it is skipped, just skip it. Probably. I'm so sorry for that. Okay. Then please skip that. That's not a mandatory step. Nothing is mandatory here till you create the project.
Okay. Neeraj. And one more thing, they're asking for the role actually. So Scrum Master, Product Owner.
Again, just put anything. Scrum Master, whatever you want. If you want to do anything. Does not make any changes here. Okay.
Okay.
I still need to know from you that who are you.
Okay.
Yeah, they basically create a database and then they suggest you any other tools.
Okay. Now we are in the invite your teammates now.
Yeah.
So I can skip. I can.
Yeah, you can skip that.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry, I got disconnected because of network.
Right. Yes, Praveen. So how far have you done with your registration process?
I am on the page where I have a question. Which of these best describes what you do?
Okay, just fill up anything, a software developer, right? Or something, and then show your role or whatever it is, and just continue. If you want, you can skip as well. That's not mandatory.
Okay. Yeah, now I'm on the screen. That is invite your teammates.
Please carry on. Ignore that, skip it.
Okay.
One quick question, Neeraj. Venu here.
Yeah.
Yeah, when we are inviting the team members should be of the same team of, or if they are from a different company.
Anyone. This is your independent instance. So you just have to mention their Gmail ID or any ID. They will get a link and they can join you. That's it.
No, with reference to the real-time scenario, if I...
real-time scenario, of course, you will only write their professional mail ID, right?
No. The professional mail ID, but if I'm a different company or different organization, I have the option to include them.
Yes. It's just email dependent. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
So if someone is from a different organization and you have their email ID, you just send them. They can join. Okay, we have a new joinee with us called as Rahul. Rahul, welcome aboard. Very good morning.
Hi, Neeraj. I just joined.
I got linked right now away.
Just please tell me where to go. Means I just opened the Atlassian site.
Okay, follow me. Just follow me. Go to Atlassian.com.
Okay, I got it. Yes.
Okay.
I already there. Then I select the Confluence. Is it that?
No. Not Confluence. On the products, you select Jira Software.
Okay, just give me a sec.
Okay. on the products menu, you drop down and select Jira Software.
Yes, yes, then.
Then you will get a button, get it for free.
Yes, yes, got it.
Click on that, they will ask you to register.
Okay.
No, the first page will be like which type of module Jira software you are using. Continue there.
Welcome back, Rahul. Your work email ID, Rahul. This is, and I just need to. It's asking claim your site, that box.
Yeah, yeah. Just give them a site name, like anything, which could be like my Rahul workspace or something like that.
Achha, achha.
You just have to create a unique site name. So you have already created an account on Jira already, right?
No, no. I went to the Confluence page and I just entered the Gmail.
Okay, okay. Got it. That's what it's, it could have been identified already. So do I understand that all of you, rest of you, are on the welcome page, like finally the product page?
It's just asking operations, sales, human resources, and all the things.
Yeah, yeah, just skip it. You don't need anything there. Wherever you see skip, please skip it.
Okay, fine.
So rest of you can please drop me a chat quickly that you are finally inside the project. Say yes. Just drop me a chat. Okay, that's good. Except Rahul, anyone else is stuck anywhere?
Now, Dhiraj, can you show me the screen, the final Please. Screen, the dashboard?
Yeah. This is the page.
Yeah, just to verify mine actually.
Yeah, sure.
I'm not getting the active sprints.
Yeah, exactly. Even I'm not getting active sprints. I'm in the
What you are having?
Roadmap, backlog.
Yeah, to do, in progress, and done. Yeah, and my board is highlighted in the left side.
Active roadmap.
You backlog. Don't have this menu option at all?
I have with the name called board.
Board. Because maybe you used a Kanban template. Is that you use Scrum template?
No, I use Scrum only.
Don't worry. I got you covered. Don't worry. Even if you don't have that active sprint right now, don't worry. Okay. But you are here, right? On this page, welcome page?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So we just want you to be here. Don't worry. I'll help you out. Because hereafter, I can recover you from any situation. Okay. So final call. Is there anyone who is still waiting to be on this page, what I'm displaying right now, with any options, whatever it is? Rahul, are you done with your process?
Yes, I'm just doing it. I'm into the help of set up your Jira. So I did it. I am experienced. My team is...
Please follow anything. And just use the option as feature. What type of activities do you work in? So go for the feature.
Schedule it ties. Okay, now where to clear? Choose a classic template.
Then select the Scrum one.
Okay.
By default, there will be a Scrum template selected. Just continue with that.
They are asking create project.
Yeah, write a name for a project. For I just mentioned it as Star Agile Training. You can have it something of your own. So there will be a key generated. If you want, the key can also be customized, like which is a shortcut of the project name.
Okay.
So if you want, you can also change it as per your comfort, but By default, it will take the first letter of each word. And just continue from there again. It will again ask you that if you want to change your template. So please don't click on that. Just click on continue further and you will be here.
So it's created. And the I'm showing a I'm getting a page. It's look like active sprints and all like that.
Is that what you're seeing on the screen right now? What I'm sharing?
Yep, the same. Yeah. Same. Yes.
Okay. Just stay there. Okay. This is what we have done so far. Okay. So I assume here that all of you, okay, all of you, including me, are on this page right now. But some of you don't see active sprint. It's because that you selected a different template by mistake. So that's what mistakes can happen. We are human beings and we are error prone. Okay. So the only mistake what you have done that you have opted for a different template than mine. And that's where you went wrong. But don't worry. You always have an option here to click on project menu and create a new project. So right now, if you want, you can create a new project, but wait for it. Okay. You don't have nothing specific to do right now. You can do it later as well. So this is your first look. So let me give you a navigation first, and then we will have a short break. And then during the break, those who are not looking, not getting this option called as active sprint, I would request you to create a new project and please select the templates as Scrum. Okay. You will find your sorted problem. Okay. So please concentrate again on the screen. Leave your instances there and listen to this. The thing what we are going to start with is first the navigation. What is navigation? You should know that what options are here on your screen right now, which is this is your common page and you will always land up here. Whenever you log in next time, you will always land up on this page itself. So on the top, of course, you have a button called as a kind of grid, which shows you what all products you are using and what other products are available, which you are not using. Okay, so whenever you click on this grid option, we get this feature that you have Jira software installed. You are using a Jira software instance and you have administrator access. Why? Because you are the one who created this instance. So by default, you are the administrator. You have other products from Jira. Okay, I would request participants to be on mute. Thank you. And these are the other products which you can actually install if you want to. So that's what I think somebody was asking me that I want to have knowledge about Confluence as well. So you can integrate these things right from here as well with your Jira software. So you will have access to both of them and you can switch between them. Next is, of course, the product which you are using. That logo will be displayed to you always here. And this confirms you which product of Atlassian you're using. If you're using Jira Core, it will show you Jira Core here. If you are using Jira Service Management, it will show you Jira Service Management here. So this part logo will confirm you which product of Atlassian you are using right now, because the look and feel will be quite similar for other variants as well, like Jira Service Desk and Jira Core. So people wonder that some options I don't see because you might be in a Jira software and that option you might have seen in Jira Service Desk. So please confirm it from this point. This place you can confirm which product you are using. Your work will show you always whatever activities you have done so far. So if I click on this, what do I see? I've just created a project and I have a new request for creating any tour or any other projects. So this is my work. So when I start doing a lot of activities, I can see my recent activity, just like Facebook wall, Facebook timeline. Right, timeline shows you your recent friends activities and this, that and all. Here it will only show you your interaction with this project, like you created an issue, you updated the status of an issue, or you created a new item. So all your activities, whatever you do, will be shown in your work. Okay, only your work. You cannot see your teammates' work. Second section is to create projects. You can always come here and navigate between multiple projects if you have. Or you can create a new project right from here. You don't have to re-register yourself, create a new instance. This instance is created once for all. And if you want, you can create multiple projects within an instance. And this is the option here to create a project. We will do that. I'll create another project and show you. Then this section will help you to have filters. Once you have a lot of issues, a lot of work items in your project, of course, the filters will help you to filter between them and target only the one which you are interested in. And we will be covering all these options. Okay, I don't want to repeat that statement again and again. So filters, we will be learning about that. The dashboards, again, dashboard shows you indicators. You got the definition of that initially. So dashboards will have multiple, you know, indicators to show. We will be configuring a dashboard and looking at it, that how we can create a dashboard. So here you will have two options. You can create a dashboard or view all dashboards, which you would have created. The section people is to allow people to join. Remember, I skipped adding the people when I was initially asked for. So now after creating the project, if I want to invite people, I can still do that by clicking on invite a teammate or start a team. Now inviting a teammate basically allows team members. And within that, I can further create teams as well. For example, I have 10 members in my project. Okay. Now three of them are developers, three of them are architects, and four of them are testers. So I have to further create teams within my instance, that one team is developer, one team is architect, one team is tester. And these three teammates are team one, these three are in team two, and these four are in team three. So yes, this option will allow you to create two things. One is invite members or team members, or create a new team as well. Okay, within your instance, you can have multiple teams and multiple team members. This is the next section, which is called as apps. That is your marketplace. Okay, you can go to marketplace and shop for any kind of plugins. We will be covering this as well, but later. And I will explore more in detail with the definition, understanding and all when I, you know, visit each of these options. And of course, this is the main button which you will have, is to create. Create what? Create an issue. Okay, you can create an issue. An issue can be of any type. Click on this and you will see the options here. These are the default issues, okay? Or we call it, in Agile, we call it as work item, okay? Work item. We have four types of work item as of now. As of now, I precisely insist on that word because we can always change it. If we want, we can add more. If we want, we can change the names. We have story, task, bug, epic, okay? These are the four things which we have got based on the template which you selected. This issue type list is completely dependent on your template which you have selected. If you have selected something else, you will have a different list of items. For example, if you select a service desk project or service management project, then you will only have two work item types, task and subtask. If I have selected Scrum, I'll have these four. So my project is Scrum template. So I'm getting these four. But remember why I'm saying as of now, because we can always add more and we can customize the Jira instance. So this is, of course, to write all the issues, and we have the author details. We will see that later. So this is the create button to create any work item type or issues in Jira project. Now, how to go back to our page? Just go to the project and click on your project which you have created. And again, you will land up the same page where you started. So by default, it will take you to active sprint. Why? Because all of you know about Scrum. I'm not sure if anyone here, somebody said you are working on service or desk management. So Agile is basically a methodology for software development process. Okay, it helps you to develop the project and create the work. And of course, manage the entire project from time to time. So active sprint is one of the part of it where we basically manage certain tasks or process certain tasks within a particular sprint. And sprint is basically a simple iteration or a duration of probably 2 to 4 weeks of time, which will determine what exactly you will be delivering at the end of the sprints. These are short cycles, unlike traditional approaches, because traditionally you work all together for probably 6 to 9 months of time and then deliver the entire product in one go. But in Agile, you deliver products in short deliverables, like simple forms. So you work on 2 week sprint and deliver something to the customer. And basically you show them that this is what we have done. Is it as per your requirement or it's going somewhere else? So customers will have a frequent review on these things, whatever you're doing every sprint. So they will say that, yes, it's correct and please proceed like this. Or customer will also get an idea that how things are being built up. If they need any changes, they will be letting you know that we would like to modify this to like this. So these kind of things happen in Agile. So a sprint is one of that. Okay. Now, what do you see here? First of all, you see a star board star is my keyword of my project. Okay. I just customize it to star. So for you, it will be according to your project key, that board will be displayed to you. Now here you see that I have got a board. I click on this. What happens? You are right now on the star board itself. Star board. Board is basically taken from Kanban. Kanban was another approach to be used within Agile, which allowed you to manage your activities on a physical board, to be frank, on a physical board, which had all the activities in multiple columns. What are the columns? To do, in progress, and done. To do means the tasks are yet to be started, or somebody should work on it. Nobody has started working on it. In progress means this task is in progress, or someone in your team is working on that, or probably you are working on that and the task is in progress. Done means it is completed and it has met the objective, whatever it was supposed to meet. Now, if you want, you can even customize these columns and have some more columns within your boards. So it's up to you. If you think you want to have another column like in testing or in review, then done. Then of course you can customize it because Jira is a customizable tool. Roadmap. Roadmap will show you your basic plan, that what is that you have planned for your overall project. So when you have an epic, epic is basically the main important part of your project, which is the parent requirement. Then epic has user stories, and user stories are further broken down into tasks. Again, these are basic things which you should have known already. So I'm not going to insist in detail. So when you create an epic, you have got a plan with you. When you create sprints, you will see those progress happening in the planner here. So as of now, we don't have anything. That's the reason. It is just showing me an orange bar on the date today. That is 9/1/2021. That's it. So as this bar will progress, and you will have a lot of things coming here, okay, as you create. So don't worry. As we create something, we will come back time to time here, and I'll show you the progress. Backlog. There are two types of backlog which we have in Agile. One is product backlog, second is sprint backlog. Initially, when a user story is broken down into tasks, all your tasks will be into product backlog, where you have everything being listed. Now, you pick up certain tasks from the product backlog and put it in the sprint backlog. Why? Because these tasks should be decided and plan that what exactly you will be doing in a particular sprint. So when you pick up certain tasks from the product backlog to be processed in a particular sprint, you call it a sprint backlog. That's it. Now, if anything is done undone during a particular sprint, it will stay there and rest new task will come back and join the sprint backlog. So that's the story between product backlog and sprint backlog. And that's the reason you call it as a backlog. What do you mean by backlog? Something you wanted to complete, but you could not complete. Just like your engineering or graduation, you had subjects, probably, I'm not sure how many of you had backlogs. I had one, of course. So you had 6 subjects to pass in a semester, and probably you passed 5 and one you failed. So you used to call it as a backlog. Why you used to call it as a backlog? Because your target was to clear 6 subjects in this semester, but you only cleared 5 of them. So one is in your backlog, and this goes to the next semester, 6 + 1. Okay. So the same way here, the logic is followed, that you have product backlog where all your activities will be lying. You only pick what you will process in a particular sprint backlog. If anything remains undone, it will stay there, and new task for the next sprint will join him along with the previous pending. Okay. Then active sprint will definitely show you the sprints which is going on right now. We will be creating them, so don't worry. A lot of these buttons are disabled right now because we have not done anything yet. Reports section will take you to the reports, and you can see what reports are available here in the Jira. And this is not all, okay? Because if you want, you can always install a new app which is going to add more reports to you in order to generate them, okay? These are some of the things which are available by default. You can always add more to this from the marketplace, that is apps. So to go back, you will have a button on the top automatically when you switch it to the window like this. You will have a button here, back to the project. So you will come back here. Then issues. This section will allow you to manage the issues. Okay, if somebody asks you, where do you do issue management in Jira? You say this button, issue button. Just click on that. You will have the complete access to manage the entire issue. You will have filter options on the top and then export issues or go to advanced search. Advanced search will take you to JQL, Jira Query Language. And all these options, we'll be doing that later when we come to the issue management. Back to project. What is component? Certain components are created as a part of your project. For example, a feature. Okay, so task is an activity which you generally create in the Agile projects. Like task is to create login page. Now, login page is to create is the task. It's an activity. But what is the component? Component is login. Or you can say that it's a feature. Sometime you might have component different than the activity. For example, activity is that when a user logs in for the first time, he should see the first item as his home page. This is the activity which you have to enable using the architecture or development of the code or anything, probably the test case. But which feature it is associated with? Login. So component will be login, and there might be different tasks associated with login. One is the user ID password. Second is the the landing page. Third will be like what kind of access he will have on this page. You know, what kind of messages he should have on this page. So we may have different tasks related to one single component, that is login. Similarly, there might be different components. And whenever you create tasks, you can link these tasks to that particular component. So we will create few components here and we will associate our tasks to that particular component to showcase that this is what you do in real time. Code. Of course, the developers will be managing their code using this particular Jira as well, but not basically Jira. Jira is not a code management tool or code review tool or something like that. You definitely have your code in a different option like GitHub, Bitbucket, and all those kind of things, right? So you can integrate your instance or GitHub path to the Jira account, this particular instance, okay? So you can just click on this, connect to Bitbucket or connect to GitHub Lab, and then you can link that to Jira. So you can see your code progress right here within Jira itself. You don't have to always switch to a different window or go to the GitHub link and see what progress has happened, what merge has happened, what integration has happened. You can directly see everything right within the Jira if you connect your account. Just like when you connect any other add-on to your browser, like browser generally have add-ons on the top, right? So you don't have to go to that window. If anything happens, you will have an add-on. For example, Google Chrome can have Facebook or any other software's add-on on them. So you don't have to go to that Facebook every time. You will see notifications on Google Chrome itself. So those are the same thing here. You can integrate your Bitbucket, GitHub, and any other resource which you're using to manage your code. And you can see the direct updates happening right here within the Jira interface. Releases. Again, somebody prompted me during the first half that how exactly I manage releases and all. So this is the section where you will manage your releases. And of course, everything will be under the release. What is a release? Release is defined as a version of the software. For example, I'm creating a software and it has a release 1.0. Now release 1.0 is a version of this product. And everything what you do, like sprint, task, progressing, test, management, whatever, is specific to that release, 1.0. You may have multiple releases, like 1.0, 1.2, 1.4. So you need to tap your activities that if I'm testing this particular piece of code, which release is it associated with? Like it might be a future release, but I'm doing it right now. Or it might be a current release. I have to do it right now. So you have to associate any activity to that particular release, which you're going to do. And of course, this is your Confluence part, project pages, but it is inbuilt. This is not exactly Confluence, but you may have some basic documentation if you don't want to use a different product called as Confluence. Because of course you can have Confluence, but that's a different product from Atlassian. But what if you have minimal documentation? Because Confluence is also licensed. Your organization has to pay to have Confluence. But you say that my expectations are minimal documentation And probably I don't need all that feature which Confluence gives me, and I have to pay that amount. So you can have an internal documentation here within Jira software instance itself. Okay, within Jira software, you will have something called as product pages, project pages, and you can have, you know, you can use the templates like blank pages, product requirement, decision, meeting notes, retrospectives. Do you see that? This is what your Confluence will do, but with more better options, more customization. But without customization, if you just want to use these standard templates, you can do it right here without using Confluence. So Atlassian basically wants to give you all kind of freedom that even if you're just using software, that is Jira software, then I should give you at least that access that you should say, oh no, he's forcing me to buy Confluence. User should not say that, that they're forcing me to buy this product. No, I give you a feature here. If you are happy with that, please continue using this. But if you think, no, you need something more, then go for Confluence. You can pay for it because you need something more. But you don't need anything more, you can be restricted to this. Add item. If you want to add anything else from an external resource or within internally, but link to this particular project, you can use these options called as add an item to this project, a shortcut to frequently use resource like probably Wikipedia or maybe anything within your organization which you are using cannot be integrated to Jira, then you can have a shortcut here. Second, you can have a repository like Bitbucket, GitHub. You can just link it here. So user has to just come here and click on it and navigate to that. And pages, just like Confluence pages. So these are the few things which you will be working on. Okay, I'm not just saying you things. We will be having a look on these things practically. And of course, the last thing is project settings, which is project administrator settings. That being an administrator of project, okay, don't confuse yourself with Jira administrator. Jira administrator is the admin of the entire software, entire tool. Project administrator is the administrator of only that particular project. Okay, so within project, we have an admin, and Jira admin is for the entire Jira. Okay, so this person will have access to certain things. For example, changing the name of the project, changing the URL of the project or project type and other description and all. Who is the project lead? You know, things can change about a project. So this will be completely restricted to the project. Plus, not only this, you can change people, you can do automation, you can have summary of the project, issue types, issue layout, workflow, screen, field, code. This is your customization option. Okay, so we will have a look on this as well. Okay, on probably day three. Day three, you will have all these access. All right, so this is your quick navigation about the Jira project view. Last but not the least, here is your user account. You can change your personal settings. You can change your profile details or account settings or log out at any point of time. Plus, there is a cog wheel here called as settings, which are specific to cloud instances. Of course, this is not complete end-to-end Jira admin access. Okay, if you are thinking to be a Jira administrator tomorrow, this is not all the options or all the features what you have as an administrator. Don't forget, you are using a cloud instance right now. All the features are only available in a server instance. Okay, so if you want to learn everything about administrator, probably in the next training, you can enroll yourself for administration session and you can learn about Jira server instance that time. Then you will not use cloud because server will give you end-to-end customization of the tool. But yes, you have some of the features here which you can customize being a cloud administrator of Jira. Okay, so are we clear with the navigation? And this is your quick start. Anytime you want a, you know, information or kind of a, you know, a tour of the tool, you can use that. But don't worry, this is what you're doing the training for. I'm going to help you with everything.